What's up, sports fans? We're gonna do a little film study. Talk about Tank Davis. For the love of sports, let's talk about it.
He had a prison, yeah. Shit happens. Niggas want me to talk about it. They love gossip. Niggas want me to talk about it. Whoa. It's all over the gram, so I'ma talk about it. You heard what happened? Niggas want me to talk about it. Whoa. Crazy. Niggas want me to talk about it. You heard what happened? Niggas want me to talk about it. Shit happens. Niggas want me to talk about it. They love gossip. Niggas want me to talk about it. Whoa. It's all over the gram, so I'ma talk about it. You heard what happened? Niggas want me to talk about it. Whoa. Crazy. Talk about it. You heard what happened? Niggas want me to talk about it. Shit happens. Niggas want me to talk about it.
So, let's go ahead and do some little bit of study on, you know, things that Tank does well, what he's going to give Lomachenko problems with, and then some of the things that may cause him problems dealing with Lomachenko. First and foremost, Tank speed. Tank has really fast hands, and Loma's no stranger to getting hit. But when you watch Tank, look at, you know, he uses that jab, but his hooks come fast. You see this guy? And then look at Tank's footwork. His step back is really quick. He has great upper body movement. You see, that wide stance is not good, but it's okay for Tank because he transitions his weight well and he doesn't skip in. You know, some of the guys with that wide step, they'll skip in. And when you skip in like that, you're off balance. See, Tank maintains his balance and, you know, it allows him to pop in and out pretty quick. Also, as you can see, these uppercuts, like Tank, look at that. He throws these vicious, really quick uppercuts, and that I believe is going to give Lomachenko some problems, because Luke Campbell, cool hand Luke, caught Loma with a couple of uppercuts. Okay, and you know, look, see that? He's really good with that. Tank slips in there, he gets that uppercut in there. One of Tank's problems is the length of his arms, but I don't, you know, Loma doesn't have, you know, a substantial reach advantage, so I'm not sure if that's going to cause too many issues for Tank Davis. But I just love the footwork of Tank. Again, that wide stance, I don't usually favor wide stance like that, but Tank special, and again, he uses a wide stance, but he doesn't skip in, like he doesn't skip in and lose his balance. This is one of the problems, not really a problem, but this is something I believe, you know, too many people. Tank's power is, in my opinion, somewhat overrated. If you look at these fighters, look at, you see this? He just caught him with massive uppercuts and the guy's still standing. Yeah, he gets the TKO, no doubt, but look at these shots. Look at slow motion. He's catching these guys clean with a lot of leverage, and they're not going anywhere. You know, he knocks him down, but they get back up. Now, you know, I've heard Tank's power be compared to Wilder's or Noy's and guys like this. Here's the thing: when Deontay Wilder, Noy, Teofimo Lopez, when they hit guys like this with that much leverage, you see how this guy's standing on the ring? Tank is throwing everything but the kitchen sink at him, and he's hitting him with some clean shots. Look at that. I'm glad they slowed it down. This guy's not slipping these shots. Look at. So, you know, has extreme power. This guy should have been down. Eyes rolled back behind his head. He should have been down if Tank had that Wilder factor, that Teofimo, that Monster Noise. These guys are on the ground and spasms when they get hit clean. Look at this guy's head bouncing around. You know, that Pedraza, I believe it is, but you know, I watched that Pedraza fight. He hit Pedraza with a lot of clean shots, and again, you don't see Wilder hit anyone with that many clean shots. You don't see Teofimo Lopez hit anyone with that many clean shots. You do not see Monster Inoue, look at that, hit anyone. You see Pedraza's head? Guys, I know that the guy has power, but a lot of these guys are, in my opinion, putting too much into his power. But he does have fast hands, man. And, you know, that's going to give Lomachenko a problem. Now, Tank's upper body movement is pretty good when on the defense. It seems like a lot of the guys he fought, he was offensively inclined because they couldn't stop him. Here's a problem, though, that Tank's gonna... See how he lunges and he got that hand down. See, Lomo's reflexes are second to none. He has excellent reflexes. And you watch these guys that Tank fights, you know, even Pedraza. They're lower level fighters. Now, Pedraza was a good fighter, but a lot of these other guys are lower level fighters. So they're basically standing there. Lomachenko has excellent movement. He's not just going to stand there to be hit. And when you watch Tank throw these hooks, another thing that's going to cause him problems with Lomachenko, he drops his hand. Whatever hook he throws, he drops that other hand. Now, I did a video on Lomachenko, and his accuracy is also second to none. And so, you know, Tank's going to have to be careful with that. But again, when you look at his power, and, you know, everyone's like, he's going to sleep Loma, he's going to knock him out. But look at this guy. You have not seen any of these fighters get off center line. Look, they just stay right on center line and wait for Tank to come hit him. That's not going to happen with Lomachenko. He's not going to stand on center line and play a punching bag. He's going to give Tank movement like he's never seen before. See these guys? They stand right there in front of Tank. Look, he went to attack, and if you miss the attack, what are you supposed to do? You're supposed to use lateral movement, a step back or something to get off the center line. Now, they don't do that. Loma's going to be all around the place. Tank is used to hitting a stationary target. You know, guys coming straight in like that. Loma's going to faint. He's going to bait him. You know, another thing that we don't see going on with Tank, and this is clearly because it's lower level fighters. In all of these fights that I've been watching, no one's trying Tank's body. Tank's not the most physically fit fighter. He's not in the gym all the time like he's supposed to. So he has to be a little tender down there in the midsection. One thing we know about Lomachenko, he's going to test your body. He's going to change levels on you like nobody else. But Tank's quickness, his footwork, you know, Tank has lateral movement. You see that? He hits, he steps back, he hits, he gets off a center line. So he's not going to just stand in front of Lomachenko either, you know. Now, body work. Tank has excellent body work, and that's going to give Lomachenko problems because Luke Campbell hurt Loma to the body. And, you know, again, I'm not saying that Tank doesn't have more power than anyone Lomachenko's face, but I'm not going to act as if Tank has the power to just go in there one or two shots and stop Lomachenko. Lomachenko has an unexpectedly good chin, a great chin. And so, you know, when you account for all of this, the fact that these guys that Tank, do you see this? I mean, look at these hits, man. And it's full leverage in these hits. So you got Wilder power. These guys are lights out. So, but I believe Tank is going to do a good job with Lomachenko. But I do believe Tank is going to see a lot of things that none of these guys have given him. You know, they throw jabs and look at him. He stays right there on center line. He leans on the rope and just let Tank beat him. So we won't see that type of thing with Lomachenko. He's going to give Tank a lot of looks that he hasn't seen before, and confuse him a lot. So I have to pick Lomachenko on this fight, and I know a lot of people are not going to like that. But, you know, I like Tank. I'm a Tank fan, but I just think Loma's going to get him. If not, come see me. For the love of sports, let's talk about it. Peace, guys.
rappers, niggas want me to talk about it. They love gossip, want me to talk about it. Whoa. It's all over the gram, so I'ma talk about it. You heard what happened, niggas want me to talk about it. Whoa.